Hello and welcome to this Dell PowerStore video showcasing how easy it is to import Dell VNX2 file resources to PowerStore. Since day one with PowerStore, we have had native import of block data. Now, with PowerStoreOS 3.0, we have expanded the support to include importing file data from VNX2. Specifically, this process involves importing virtual data movers and their file systems. This capability is included with PowerStore natively and doesn't require any additional hardware or associated costs. With this process, the data will be able to use all the new innovative features of PowerStore. Now, let's get into the demo of the VNX2 file import process. Here is the main dashboard of PowerStore Manager. The PowerStore appliance in this environment is running PowerStoreOS 3.0. Having a file mobility network is a prerequisite of this import process, so you'll first need to go to the Settings menu and the Network IPs section. Here, under the File Mobility Network, notice that three IPs are already configured. Now, navigate to the Migration drop-down menu and select the Import External Storage option. The different storage platforms that are supported for import are listed on the right. Click Add Remote System and select VNX2 for the type, since that is the source array system for this demo. Choose File for the capability and enter the IP and credentials for the VNX2 control station. The control station IP is how PowerStore discovers and manages the migration. Click Add, validate the VNX2 certificate, and click the Confirm button. This step checks the compatibility of the VNX2 system and adds it to PowerStore. Now that the discovery is complete, click Confirm. Notice that VNX2 is now shown in the remote system list. For the next step, go to the File Import window and click the Add button to create the interface. This allows you to map an IP to a port on the PowerStore appliance. Enter the IP address, subnet mask, gateway, and VLAN ID, and click Add. Now you can see the interface has been created. This interface allows PowerStore to perform the import of the file resources from the VNX2. Now, go back to the Remote Systems pane, check the box next to the VNX2, and click Import NAS Server. Notice that after the array discovery was completed earlier, PowerStore has discovered the virtual data movers and associated file systems. By expanding VDM1, you can see the FS1 file system that it contains. Select VDM1 and click Next to import it. Check the production_IF interface from VNX2 and click Assign Network Interface. This step assigns the network interface of the VDM to an interface on the PowerStore appliance. You can select the interface from the drop-down menu and click Apply. Validate that production_IF is now assigned to the IP port 12 network interface and click Next. Now, you can give the file import session a name and schedule the import to begin immediately, which is the default option. You can also schedule the import session to start at a particular time. Then, enter the SMB credentials. You can also select the import interface IP that you created earlier and click Next. This IP is used to copy data from the source system. You can also create the interface in this step by clicking Add Import Interface link if it wasn't created previously. You can also assign a protection policy when creating the import session, but that step is not covered in this demo. The last screen allows you to review everything, and you can begin the import job by clicking the blue button. You can see in the upper right corner of PowerStore Manager that the process to create the file import has started. You could also go to the monitoring pane and click Jobs to view the status of the file import session. Click the job to bring up the Details menu. After some time, the status changes to Completed with a green checkmark. Close the Job Details menu and go back to the Migration and Import External Storage menu. Click the File Imports pane, and you can see that the current operation is in Initial Provisioning. This status transitions from Initial Provisioning to importing config to ready for cutover. Notice that the current operation of the file import session is ready for cutover. To select the file import session, check the box, and from the Import Actions menu, click Cutover. The Cutover Import menu appears, letting you know that the cutover process will not stop I/O between the source VNX2 and the PowerStore. Make sure to validate that you can access the data from the PowerStore before performing the cutover. You can also select the Cancel option from the Import Actions menu if you want to cancel the import for any reason. Now we are changing the NetBIOS name from SIFS to SIFS Old. During the cutover process, the NetBIOS name will change to SIFS Old on the VNX2, and SIFS will be used on the PowerStore. Click Apply, and the file import session cutover process status is shown on the upper right side of PowerStore Manager. The current operation also shows that it is cutting over. Go to Monitoring and Jobs again, and you can see the status. Click on the file import session to see the job details. After the status changes to completed, close the menu and go back to Migration and Import External Storage. The File Imports pane now shows that the session is ready to commit. Click Import Actions and click Commit to open the final commit menu. This menu states that the data transfer between the two storage systems will be stopped and the import session will be marked as committed. Again, this is an opportunity to ensure that you can access data as expected. You can still cancel the import at this point, but after the commit, you will not be able to go back. Click Commit, and once again, the status of the commit process is shown on the upper right side of the screen. You can monitor the status in the Monitoring and Jobs menu as shown. After the process completes, go to the File Imports menu and validate that the import state is completed as shown with a green checkmark. Lastly, if you go to the Storage and NAS Server and File Systems menu, you can see the imported objects. Notice that VDM1 is in the NAS Servers page, and FS1 is in the File Systems menu. This concludes this demonstration on how to import Dell VNX2 files to PowerStore. You can see how easy it is to perform this file migration. To get more information about PowerStore, please check out these links for additional resources such as white papers, videos, and other resources. Thanks for watching.